Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's take a look at things you may not know you could do using TextEdit. MacMost is supported by more than 600 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So TextEdit, of course, is an app that comes with your Mac, and it's a lot more powerful than people think. So as you probably already know, TextEdit has two modes, plain text editing mode and rich text editing mode. You could switch between the two of them by going to Format, and then you either see Make Rich Text if you're in plain text mode, or Make Plain Text if you're in rich text mode. We'll start off by looking at things that you can do in plain text mode. So here I have some sample text, and there are two modes for wrapping the text. Here I've got it wrapping according to the width of the window. If I move the window here, you could see the text rewraps according to the size of the window. This is very different than how you'll see things in a word processor like Pages, where there's a specific page size. But you can switch to wrap to page in plain text format by going to Format, Wrap to Page, and then you have a page size here, and the wrapping will stay the same no matter what the size of the window. Most of the time in plain text mode, you probably want it to wrap to the window. Now, of course, in plain text, you can't change text styles. You can't make things bold or italic or change the size. But you can change the font that is used to display everything here. If you go to TextEdit, Preferences, and then under New Document, you can look for Font, and there's Plain Text Font, and you could click that to change to something else, and that will change the size for everything. Note that you have to close the document out and then reopen it to see the change. There was also there, by the way, the default font for a rich text document. And you could set the default window size. So here it's set to 90 characters, but say if I wanted it to be 50 characters, I could do that. That's only for new documents, or when I go back to open this plain text document, you could see it opens much narrower now. Now while there's not too much you can do in terms of formatting for plain text documents, you can insert page breaks. So if you want to divide up a set of notes and have a forced page break, you can put the cursor where you want it to be, then go to Edit, and then Insert and Page Break. And here you'll just see it as a line. But if I go to Format, Wrap to Page, you could see how those two paragraphs are on one page, then the page break will actually take it to the next page here. Now often we use TextEdit to edit text documents that are actually code, like HTML code, CSS. If you're doing that, a common thing you need to do is jump to a certain line. Like you get an error message and it'll say the error is on line 53. You can do that in TextEdit by going to Edit, Find, and here you'll see all the normal find things, find and replace, but you also see select line, which is Command L. So we use the keyboard shortcut Command L. You can enter a line number and you can see how it jumps right to that line. An interesting hidden little feature that works in plain text and rich text mode is to kind of lock the document by going to Format, Prevent Editing, and this locks it. And now you can't actually edit the document. That is until you go to Format, Allow Editing. So it's not really a security measure. It may be just something for you to use when you want to make sure you don't accidentally change the text. Now let's go and change this to rich text mode here. And now we have a lot more options. One kind of hidden one is under File, you've got Show Properties. And there's a set of properties for each rich text document. You could set author, organization, etc. Now these are useful for your own organization, but it's also good to note that these will show up in spotlight searches. So if you had some comments or keywords here and you do a spotlight search, you'll find this document even if that keyword is nowhere to be found in the actual text of the document. Now you can also insert media if you're using rich text documents. So let's create a space here and I'm going to drag a photo from the Finder into TextEdit. Now when I do that, it's going to ask me to change the format. So you can see here it explains that there are actually two RTF formats, RTF and RTFD. And when I convert it to rich text, it did RTF as the standard format. But it needs to go up a level from that and go to RTFD, which allows attachments. So I'm going to say sure, fine, convert this document to RTFD. and that will allow this attachment here. And you can see this image here. Now a few things about inserting images. One is you can't resize them in TextEdit, and you also can't really place them. They're placed in line in the text, and I can do things like center that line and it will center that image. Now a really cool thing that you can do with it though is mark it up. Notice I have the little markup tool there just like you see if you're using Mail or another app that supports markup tools. I can click on that, and actually other third-party extensions may show up in here as well. But I can go to Markup, and then I have all the markup tools that you might see in Preview. So I can draw on it. I could add shapes. I could add text like captions. I can also rotate it here or crop it if I wanted to. And then hit Done, and the cropped version will now appear in here. So while you should actually resize the image before you bring it into TextEdit, you can do some things with it once you have it in here. Now you can also insert other things. You can insert audio and video. So I'm going to drag and drop an MP3 file in here and place it there. Now strangely it doesn't really look like much at first. It's because it's actually a pretty large little player image there and I have a small line. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to adjust the line height here. I can click here and only go up to double the size. I'll actually click here and go to more, and I'll make it exactly, and let's say something like 120 points. And now you can see most of the player there with a little playback button and everything. Let's try it with a video. So I'll take a sample video here, drop that in, and it's actually going to give me a warning because this is so big that it wants to make sure I really want to insert this into this file. I can choose to have an alias to it. So in other words, the file is still external to this TextEdit file. And now I have a little playback window and everything like that. So if you really want audio or video in your TextEdit files, you can do it. Another thing you can do is insert links. So you can select some text here and you can go to Edit and then Add Link. And then you could type a URL here and we'll convert the text you had selected to a link. If you had no text selected, it would actually insert the link text as the link. So there are other things you can insert as well. You can go to Format and insert a simple list, but you can also do a more complex table. And then you get this whole little interface here where you can set the number of rows and the number of columns, horizontal and vertical alignments, cell borders for whatever cell selected, even cell backgrounds. You can even nest tables inside each other. So you can do a lot of creative things by using tables. You also have styles, which are kind of like the styles in Pages, but they work very differently. So for instance, we select some specific text and you can see this button here, it gives you access to styles. So let's go and make this something like a little bigger font, maybe make it bold. And let's say I want to make that a regular style I'm going to reuse throughout the document. So I can click here, go to Show Styles. Now you can view the styles in this document or go to your favorite styles, which is what you want. You'll see a list here of the same things that you saw when I click that button. So I could decide to add this style there, go back to Document Styles, and it shows me what I have selected, then Add to Favorites. Now I can give this a name. Let's call this Special 1. And I can choose what to include. I'm going to include the font as part of the style. I'll hit Add. Now I'll select some other text. And I'll click here and I'll see Special 1 is listed. I'll select that and you can see it changes that text to that style. If I click here and go to Show Styles, I can go back to Favorite Styles, look through the list, there's Special 1, and it shows me exactly what it will change here. It changes the font to Helvetica, makes it bold, 24 point. And I can hit Select to select all of the text within the entire document that uses that style. So you could see here I selected both those pieces of text. That's kind of neat. There's a lot of powerful functionality there if you want to explore how TextEdit uses styles. Now what I've got here is a rich text document, but I can actually save this out as HTML. So this is handy if you're maintaining a website and you want to create a simple page that has some formatting. It can't use attachments. It can only use text, but it will maintain things like the style of the text, links that you may have, and other elements. To save it out as an HTML document, I can go to File and then hold the Option key down so I do Save As. So I'll be saving a copy of this as something else. And at the bottom I can choose the file format. And one option there is a web page. So I could save this out to the desktop as a web page. And you could see it here as an HTML document. If I double click on that, it'll open up in Safari. And you could see here the text styles are kept the same. Even that link is kept the same. Now you have some preferences for that. In TextEdit Preferences, under Open and Save, HTML saving options here allow you to set the document type, styling, whether the CSS is embedded inline or not included at all, which encoding to use, and whether or not white spaces are preserved using special characters. Now if you take an HTML document like this and you drag and drop it onto TextEdit, it will open it up using the formatting inside of HTML. So you can actually go back into the HTML document like this. But there's a setting for this. If you go into TextEdit Preferences under Open and Save, you can check off Display HTML Files as HTML Code instead of Formatted Text. This allows you to edit HTML documents using the code in them. So now if I drag and drop on a TextEdit, you'll see I can see the HTML code. And this is not just useful for something you created in TextEdit, but if you want to edit the code of HTML documents using TextEdit, you want to check that preference box so now you can actually see all the code and you're working in plain text. Another thing you can do with TextEdit is open up Microsoft Word documents with it. You can do the same thing in Pages. TextEdit is a little simpler. It's just going to give you the text and some very basic styling. But if you take a Word document file like this one, drag it onto TextEdit, it will open it up so you could read what's inside. Very handy when somebody sends you an email that's got a Microsoft Word attachment to it and you don't have Word. But if you want, you could also create Microsoft Word documents with this, because you may have noticed when I went to create an HTML document by using Save As, that another option here was to save either as a docx or doc format Word document. So you can see there's a lot of power inside of TextEdit. A lot of tasks that people use Pages or Microsoft Word for, they could just use TextEdit for. It's a really lightweight app, creates really small files, and using it instead of a big word processor is a good productivity hack. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.